For example, water having less viscous and very thin. So it is very less viscous. When you are just think about it, honey, okay, that is high viscosity. So just imagine, just take some honey in a styro cup, just pour it in some other drink or some other flask or something. So you can observe that it's very difficult to pour it in the cup. Why? The reason is the viscosity very high. Applying the stress to the materials, okay, the linear friction is very constant. So that is Newtonian. Okay, so when you are applying the stress to the polymer materials, so the shear thinning and shear thickening will be high. So if you are applying this stress to the materials, so the shear rate will be increased. So that is non-unit materials. Non-unit materials is polymer or gel or something, paste or some honey. These are non-Newtonian materials. So new, that is shear. Okay, I will give some demo.
Currently, so
this is, we are giving some force.
Okay.
This is the high molecular weight polymer. So I just smallly give the stress, just take out. Okay, so I giving the stress to the material, very less stress. So it means the material is viscous. When you are applying stress very high quickly, material is coming. So it is in the original state with care. Okay? So this is the called viscoelastic material. Okay, so we have prepared the materials. These are non-Newtonian materials, oil, some other polymers. So these are keratin based materials. We know that keratin is synthesized from human hair. So we have synthesized the keratins from human hair and hydrolyzed the materials and grafted to the some acrylic monomers. So to get acrylic polymers, this is acrylic polyacrylic polymer. So the material is used for leather coatings, leather retaining. This is a material we have used. So this material we can used by using viscometer, Brookfield viscometer. So usually viscometer we can identify two different form. It's a simple one is Oswald viscometer, and this another one is Brookfield viscometer.
Yeah.
So these are this is Oswald viscometer. We can manually measure. Okay. Different
and doing the diffusion of the water molecule.
One is inside this.
Yeah, this. Or the boiled water. That is slow movement of the solution.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
In case of hypotonic, we have diluted solution hypotonic. So, this is the swell level. Isotonic level, the division of water molecule text is the same. So, this is the remains. So, this is the remains. So, this is the recomponent. This is the hyper level. This is the swelling.
Thank you.
From a G to a mRNA to protein. So here we are demonstrating an easy way to how to isolate a genetic material DNA. So it's a simple method. See, same concept is used for isolation in the lab also. Here we are, if you want you can do, try it with your homework. Here what we are doing is we are taking onions, then cutting into small pieces and putting that in a detergent plus salt. So that most of the proteins and other this thing get solubilized in those detergent, and then we'll filtrate it. In the filtrate, that will salt as well as soap will precipitate other components, and the filtrate will contain the genetic material. The genetic material that is coming into the filtrate is precipitated out by putting it in ethanol. Anything you can use. Here we are using absolute ethanol. You can use beer, rum, anything you have at home. Just pour it and see. It will precipitate out, and that material is coming out. Then the question is why we should isolate. Is having any idea? Identification of what?